we should be live in like 10 seconds, 20 seconds.
Okay, coach.
Fool, I had these boys pushing weight. Look at this.
These kids are in 8th grade, so they're not even freshmen.
We're live, guys.
Still, fuck.
Oh, wow.
Fuck. Let's go audio, bro.
That's weird.
The lights are not on. The lights are not on the rig. I shut the battery off right there. Aren't they supposed to have green lights on?
No, it was on before, though.
Here. I'm going to sit behind you if you fucking die that fast. I'll get a fucking... You know girls order batteries by a month? You know, like, they deliver, like, water to your house? Girls get batteries. That's... It stopped it. That was before, though. That was 10 seconds, whatever you did 10 seconds before.
I knew it was the fucking transmission.
Stop.
I can't hear us on your thing.
Are we talking? What about when I say this?
Oh! Look, I plugged it back in. Now I'm going to unplug it. Watch. We'll go off right now.
Oh, there you go.
There, see?
Is it completely off? It's something to do with that. Oh, now it's bad. It's that. I think it's the batteries.
Are it is the battery, you think?
We got two right there behind you. Fucked up big three. It's just big us.
Guys, we're going to figure this out no matter what, because we're always, no matter what, going to put out good shit for you.
This is actually dope because they get to see how real this shit is.
We have no guests. Like, we're fine. We can even go live at 10. Who gives a fuck? I don't know where to go.
Yeah.
Figure this shit out. This is a good test run. Here's what it is.
But you know what? It's always something.
Oh, see, that's the way it should be right there.
Yeah, the lights are bright.
Both our lights are on now.
Hey.
None? That's what it was, bro. Fucking piece of shit. Just two batteries, bro.
I shut it off at the
we
end
need
of the
to
show.
Buy. I'll buy a fucking 24 pack of that, so it never happens again. But you know what?
How do we sound there?
Rock.
Yeah, rock. Put that in. It's always something until it's nothing.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
No, this was a fuck. It's gonna show them if you really want to get some shit done, you got to work through it, bro.
Yeah, you got to. You got to, Ryan Garcia.
We're good.
You hear the volume?
Oh, I still need to watch the whale.
Fuck. Oh. Amazing, bro.
Should we do a segment of our favorite movies?
Fool. Yes, no,
I'm not
whale.
A movie guy like
that's
that.
Probably,
but
that's
yes,
probably the best acting
movie.
I've seen.
It's a great fuck.
The from acting the Looney Tunes guy?
Fool. Oh, Encino Man killed it, bro. Tell you that right now.
That are was you, like wait, on, what are you guys doing Gilbert Wednesday? No one wants shit, to watch Pauly Shore with me?
We're here?
Yeah. I'll be in area.
It's the first.
I'll be in Nashville.
Oh, never mind. Like, I was like, fool, for guarantee, sign me up. Yeah, I think it's May 1st.
What's the big threes on? 40 people are watching.
Perfect.
All right, let's wait a little bit.
It sounds good to me, right?
That's how it should sound.
It's a battery then. Now we fucking know.
A simple battery, guys. Just know that.
Okay, you ready?
Well, Jay Nasty had to buy the cheapest batteries probably in town.
Fucking fag.
I'm sure he had them in his car. We'll act like he bought it.
Here we go, guys. Let's fucking rock.
Bought it.
Hey, let's fucking do it again. We get a second opportunity.
We get a
and
second
chance. Let's fucking
not
go.
A lot of fools get second chances
no,
in life.
No, dog, let's go.
Except us, because we cheat and they always
let's
come
go,
back.
Let's go, puppy.
This.
Dude, you're an idiot.
I know, but I caught you with that one. Take it from the top. How about you get on top?
Here's my story.
There we go. And we can play a little bit now because we're good, man.
About a girl.
Oh, now I'm feeling greater. My mic, I feel, but I'm cool.
She took my
Live and learn, baby.
Hey,
let's
we got this, baby. I got the baddest team in the motherfucking planet.
G-Money, let's fucking hear this shit. No lane, sell out, ready? Boys. Let's fucking go. Let's now.
Let's go! I held that one on a little longer, baby. Because I got the baddest motherfucking team in the building. I got my boy Rocky Nash on the ones and twos. I got my boy motherfucking Hightown. Come on, everybody. Come on, bring them titties out. Bring them dicks out. Come on.
G-Money, for the first time. Let's go.
I keep away from a run around Sue. Hey, come on. We got the Sal Out boys in the building. For those of you that don't know, but we'll talk about that in a minute.
One more time, G-Money.
Keep away from a run around Sue. Yeah! Come on, everybody. Welcome to No Lames. And I've said it before, and I'll say it again. This is the baddest motherfucking podcast in the motherfucking world. And I stand by that shit. Because I got two of the baddest motherfuckers on my team now, bro.
Let's go, bro. Hey,
because fuck the big three. It's just big us. Me. No,
G Money. At the end of time, at the end of the day, nobody could hold us down, bro.
Not even a battery.
Oh shit! Hey. Yo, no Diddy, free Diddy, free Diddy. He's innocent. Whoa, but what happened to like innocent until proven guilty, dog?
Okay, let's. I kind of we talked about it. Like, first of all, we want to talk about shit that we talk about just off the fucking camera. Puff Daddy, I mean, I guess innocent to proven guilty. There's a lot of conspiracy theories going on. There's a lot of whole shit. And I talked to Tone, and like, I don't know what the fuck to believe anymore. Like politics, watching Fox, you argue different CNN. I don't know. Like, it's just so, it's just, I go, at the end, I like Israel, Palestine. And now I'm like, I don't know who you even go for. Like, fool.
Well,
and I just don't know.
But this is what sucks, dog. This is what's sad, is that no matter what you believe in, there's always going to be another side that's going to try to break you down and create some sort of conflict between you and whoever else believes in something else. Yeah. Like, nobody could just be fucking happy and believing in, hey, there's a God and we're going to go to heaven if we act right. Now, it's everything is full. You got to watch what you say, what you do. Did Diddy do it? Did OJ do it? Did Ryan Garcia do a bump? Like, there's always conflicts now, dog. Yeah. Like, you can't just fucking, we can't just be cool, bro. Why is that?
We can't just think what we want to fucking think anymore. Like you said, dog, like, people are always trying to change your mind about something, bro.
You could, like, this is the thing, like, and like, I've changed my opinion on a gang of stuff. Like, and it's okay to change your opinion or your thoughts. Oh, hey, fool, last year on Nashville, you said this. I go, well, you know, I changed my mind now. And
exactly.
That's fine. I'm not going to be so prideful where I'm not going to change my mind. But there's a lot of shit that's going on where, bro, if you believe in that, that's between you and death. Like, when you die, that's on whatever you believe. Like, bro, like, oh, you're a Christian. Get out there. I go, bro, like that's what I believe in. And I'm not going to, it just,
bro, I trip out on how people can bring something up that you said 12 years ago.
Oh my God.
Not supposed to change, or like, you can't just be like, man, bro, like, when I said that I was 17, I didn't know what I was saying.
Oh, but they'll bury you alive.
Life for that, bro. Like, it's,
and this is what's crazy, right? Because like, for those of you that don't know, I coach at fucking, I don't want to say the high school because they'll probably try to get me fired, but I coach high school football and they're really into like
cheating.
No, shut the fuck up.
Don't get started with that.
Don't get started. It's that they're really into like, so one of the head coaches on my team, like, he is one that prepares kids for college and how recruits are going to talk to them and the way they should be handling life.
Media training. Those are schools you want to be at.
So they're talking about like who you shouldn't follow on Instagram, things you shouldn't say.
Example, G-Money.
Like, I mean, I wouldn't say don't go and follow like any type of, I don't know, anyone that would be considered racist or and like, you know what I'm saying? Like shit like
or
that.
Hateful or
any type of negative shit. Because, and things you're going to say, because dude, there was a quarterback, bro, was expected to go fucking first round, right? He's in the car when he's 16 years old and he's with his homeboys. He grew up in a black neighborhood and they're in the car and he's singing, rapping a song where it says the N-word. But he's saying it with his homeboys that are N-words, right?
Yes.
I mean, that are black guys. Yeah. But he grew up, that was part of his culture. Like, people probably don't understand that and they'll bury that fool alive. But when you grew up there and you're saying it because those are the only homies you had or the people you had, and they call it, like, some people call it an N-word pass, but that's, it's not right. I'm not saying it's right, but that's just where the kid grew up. Yeah, he was 17, 16 and he was years
singing
old.
Singing a song, probably.
Singing a song. And they pulled all his fucking. His D1 offers away.
And that's how you...
Can you believe that, dog? D1 are...
That's sad. And that's how, like... So, for me, like... Mexican growing up... Oh, your essay. Don't talk like... But there was homies that grew up in Compton. South Central. Or the West Side. Homie, they went to school with all blacks.
Yeah.
That's the way they talk. So, who am I to say, hey, bro, don't talk... Like, homie, you didn't grow up right here, dog. Like, you know what I mean? So, they
it's
just
your
talk,
environment,
and,
right?
And that's what it says, like... I changed my opinion. Yeah. Like, it just...
And that's
fine. I mean, honestly, bro, if you grew up in Covina or something... Dog,
Don't say it, chill, bro. Yeah.
Like, you, like, chill with that. So, but it's just growing, and that's how
you... Yeah, or Monte, like, you know...
So, going into what you were saying about the... About, real quick, about this, like, guy who's media training and, like, saying, hey, what not to fall... Like, in your opinion right now, your kid is 13, he wants to be a boxer. Yeah. Are you allowing him... to study what Ryan Garcia is doing right now?
No, bro. No.
Or is that an embarrassment?
Like, it's an embarrassment, bro. I'm not going to lie. Like, so my son boxed, right?
Cool.
My son boxed at Valverde right here in Azusa, and I loved it. But I had him looking up to boxers like Ryan Garcia at the time, because Ryan Garcia was a hardworking, straight to the point. Because boxing, when it comes down to it, these dudes are cut from different cloths. Yes, Mayweather did change the game a little bit where he was just a little more talkative, but that motherfucker trained hard. No one ever said Mayweather is fucking doing blow or like he, like, you know, you probably knew he partied, but that motherfucker trained hard.
The only thing about Mayweather is that he danced a lot.
Yes.
No, and he brought a different vibe to boxing, right? Like his showboating, his money, his this, he talks shit, but guess what? He's not doing that coming off of a loss where you drop to a knee and you
He quit.
Okay, so if you got beat up and you quit a fight, you're not even allowed to talk shit no more, bro, and pull these antics that Ryan Garcia is pulling, in my opinion. You are kind of like a disgrace to... You're disrespecting boxing, the sport, bro.
I think he is, bro. I think he's...
I don't even think disrespecting boxing, just disrespecting... human nature.
And what do you think, Rock? Because I know you're out of the table. You're I don't.
I hate saying religious.
No, I hate saying. I mean, like, but you're more
in tune with that. Yes.
Can I say that? Does that sound more appropriate?
In tune.
Faith, yeah. Faith driven.
I would say I'm practicing more.
Okay.
I think we all love God. We all love Jesus.
100%.
100%. I just think maybe I practice it more.
You do.
I like that.
And that's all it is.
That's what I meant. Yeah. But how do you feel like he's doing these crazy shit and then he's always like...
And I'm a fan.
Talking about God.
Yeah, no, that's my thing. Like his last fight with Tank, I was like... And for me, and I can't speak for Tone, but I disliked him for some personal reasons.
Yeah.
Just for some unfollowing stuff, you know? Just
some weirdo.
Some weird stuff. I was like, okay, you know what? Hope he gets knocked. You don't follow me? Hope he gets knocked down now. On some bitter stuff, like, if I'm being honest.
No, if you don't follow me,
But when he came out to Hillsong as Tank, I was like, let's go, Ryan. Like, yeah. I was going for Tank the whole time. Like, I'm Tank. When he came out to Hillsong, to Oceans, I was like, get him, Ryan. Yeah. Let's get him.
Something about it brought you back to that.
Do you kind of feel, because to me, I feel like he's using
faith
and God for people to follow him and be like, oh no, he's faithful.
I feel like a lot of
people. And he's laughing in people's
not
face.
Not only Ryan Garcia, but there's people that use that Bible to get laid or the Bible to get the job.
Really?
Fool.
Shut the fuck up. Fools are going to church and boning?
Carl Lay. I mean, there's pastors that do it.
Wait, what church?
I mean, there's church groupies, bro. It's just, especially if you're at a mega church. Wait. But there's homies that get out, you know the word, hey, girl, I need to pray for you. Oh, now we lay for you. I've heard of guys that'll
they'll go pray for, go have Bible studies at their pad.
Fool.
And then when it's over, like, hey, stay after.
100%.
I have a word for you. And they just try to touch them and be weird.
And
that true?
No, that's a hundred. That's those are facts, bro. Those are straight facts. Like,
so, but isn't God getting mad at that?
No, they of course. Bro, yes, like, yes, of course. They're just taking advantage of a situation.
But isn't that worse than not being part of church?
1,000% because well, if you know better,
a,
then it's
it
worse.
It says in a Bible, like, so pastors, the people that know the Bible that don't do better, they have a worse after death than
oh, regular. Really?
Yes, 100%. Wow. They got a worse.
So I'm good in
so
a way.
So if you know the Bible and you know the word and that's your thing and you're not doing it, like God's like, no, you know better, dog. Yeah. Like you, it's like living in a house. Like it's coming from a foster home and, you know, doing this and you don't know what a real home is. But like G-Money, like, you grew up in a household, like, you know better than
I
that.
I do, yeah.
Like, you know,
yeah.
Like, you know better, dog.
And you know what's crazy is that when you know better, your guilty conscience
right
eats
away.
You alive, dog. Like, fools that don't give a fuck about religion, consequences, have nothing. When they do something wrong, bro, it don't eat them up because they don't care. They don't know.
100. So this is what I tell.
This is, it's harder.
This is what I tell everybody, bro. I go, because when I first started going to church and I got more into it, I will tell people, like, I wish I didn't start going to church. What do you mean? I go, because now I can't enjoy things that I used to enjoy. Like, oh. I can go and smash some chicks, smash this chick, get drunk, get in a fight, do whatever, and there was no conscience.
Exactly,
there was nothing that, like, you know what I mean? I didn't have, like, I was like, I'm good. So now when I knew the word and I knew better, I just couldn't enjoy it anymore because now, like, I just had this conscience on me.
The conviction after, bro, is the worst.
So I was like, man, like, I'll be in Hillsong with at nighttime, and I'll even take chicks to Hillsong with me, whatever. And then I'm thinking, like, man. And then I go, it goes to Solomon. Solomon, like, he's the smartest man. This is what I was talking about. Solomon is he's David the Kukulite. That's his son. Solomon asked God, God, what do you want? Like, you know, he's all, I want to be the wisest man ever, pretty much, right?
Yeah.
So God goes, oh, cool. Like, so he makes Solomon the smartest guy that exists in the Bible, right?
Yeah.
Smartest guy in the world, bro. In the Bible,
that's,
right?
That's dope.
Still a player. Still, and he talked to God.
Yeah, because he's so smart. He's
he got play bitch. Fool. He had over 700 wives.
That's a lot of wives.
Richest man in the world.
Wait, do you think they over-exaggerated on the number of wives?
No. Because not
700?
Even 700? But he had more because he had slaves that he slept with. Jeez. That this is just.
And he married all of them?
So his thing was like, let's say he knows religion, but he's all this girl. Let's say she's believes in goats for gods. He'd go, well, man, girl, I believe in goats too. What's up? Like, bro.
Yeah. He was just,
bro. He was out of control. But God took that enjoyment away from him where he couldn't. And this guy, the richest dude, the smartest dude, how all the girls, he goes, God took the enjoyment away from me. He goes, I can't even enjoy this anymore. Like, wow. So he couldn't enjoy it anymore. So as for me, when you know God, you just can't enjoy it the same way as you would. Like before, I go, man, that was cool. I'll go bright high fiving now. Like if I were to get with a chick, like I wouldn't even tell anybody because I feel like a piece of shit.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? It's so crazy. That's what we're saying. So for Ryan Garcia, we're going with the G-Money. And that's your Bible lesson, everybody, for today. But I go with Ryan Garcia, so he knows better. And he's just making like a mockery of the Christian lifestyle.
I think he is.
So now, like, bro, like, me, like, I don't see God blessing him, like, in this fight.
How many rounds?
Oh, bro.
Let's all do a bet right now on life, all of us.
I'm saying I'll give you over under. It's not going to go over 6.
Oh, I'm right there, too.
I think it's going over 8.
Over 8?
Yeah.
That's 9 rounds.
That's a lot, bro.
I think so. That's just my bet. We
G-Money, where
you
at with this?
Look, I'm going to go 5. Fuck it.
Okay.
I'm going to go 5, dog.
5 or 6?
Yeah.
5 or
so
6?
So let's just go 5, 6.
And 9.
9.
Okay.
All right. Cool. That's cool. We'll settle it there.
We are talking about some player shit. Arnold Barbosa, bro. Like, now go from this to that. Give me your opinion on that.
Like, this is the thing, bro. And shout out to Arnold, bro. He's
hey, shout out to the Blockout Podcast. What's up?
Yeah, shout out to the fucking Blackout
Shader Brown.
ODM. I heard he's packing,
in the
dog.
Building, bro.
He's packing now.
I heard he could have had 700 wives, but he's like, no, I just want one, dog.
Hey, shout out to
that.
Shout out to him.
That's like you guys.
ODM.
Just
Only Dick Mama. That's what he got.
We're not supposed to read the comments. I know. What are we doing? That's ODM, bro.
We can't ignore that.
You can't, bro. And it's not even Sunday, dog.
I know. We are talking about church, though.
We are. Based, oh, wow, that was a sign. All right. But this is what I'm saying, dog. Look, shout out to Arnold Barboza, bro. He's been here. Humble dude. From Malta, even brought it up over there in New York.
Oh, talking about humble, he wears Hokas.
Oh my God, this one will never end with that. But like that dude, he went to his press conference looking sharp as fuck. Every one of his videos he's put out or anything because we know him personally.
It's not a big deal.
Arnold's not doing anything weird. Arnold's out there training because he's not okay with being comfortable. He wants to fucking see. He even said, I don't want that shit to say Garcia.
Haney.
I want that shit to say Barboza.
Versus everybody. Hey, Jiminy, a quick thing. If I know, like, being single, whatever, like, if I had a big fight in Vegas, like his last fight in Vegas, and I won the fight, I'm partying.
Yes.
Lingerie of Dalla Hoya.
100% lingerie.
You know what I mean?
Lingerie and cocaine.
You know, this guy, Barboza. Went to dinner with his family, dog.
He did.
And G-Money had to be security, whatever. But that's how humble this dude is. It's hard not to root for this guy.
It's hard not to, bro. Especially meeting him. Like, he's just a good dude. And it's a type of dude, like, he's surrounded by a good foundation. Because that's where it comes from, Olin's bro.
Only podcast.
Yeah. Like, he's right there with his dad over there. You could tell his dad took care of him and his dad was there for him. And that's just showing you guys, like, the future of where life should be. Like, we need to be there for our kids, especially right now. If you have a young kid, like, you want to make sure that they're following the right path because you misleading or you letting your kid roam off and do other shit, he's gonna fucking do his own fucking shit. And look, I don't see Ryan Garcia posted up with his pops, posted up with his family. We've been with Barboza where it's family because family comes first, like fucking Muhan, what is it? The Lilo and Stitch or fucking Fast and the Furious.
Lion King, the
Prime. But bro, like how good is that where he posted a picture with his dad? Me and my dad, you know, like versus everybody again. Like
that's is good and even born about my bad tone, but even with like Concrete, bro. He did the last this kind of people were saying like we surround ourselves with people. Yes. Winners for one thing. Concrete closed out Laugh Factory in Vegas, last show ever. His dad, he was on stage with his dad crying, hugging his dad, both crying. To me, I looked at that post, it was like, that's my fucking boy right there, dog. Yeah. Not my boy just fucking all these bitches or doing coke or talking like Ryan Garcia. Like, Concrete, that's my fucking boy right there, dog.
That's beautiful, though. That's why.
I mean, and we all need that, bro. We see when we, let's talk about the live show we just sold out, the first one, right?
Yeah, No, but look. Whatever, fool. You want to talk about it, whatever.
We had family in there, bro. We had moms. We had your pops.
Fool, your mom had a fucking nice rack.
Bro.
Telling your mom does have a nice
bro, you, hey, the good homies talking about my mom's titties.
No, I'm just saying I'm so jealous.
Oh, her
no
jacket. What? Fool, what?
Stop.
No, I'm not. I'm jealous that she was breastfeeding. You were sucking them titties as a baby.
Well, is this super bad?
Super bad.
It's super bad.
Now we're quoting movies, dog.
Steph never gets a joke. Steph gets a joke. You don't. He's not a movie dude. No. You don't get the joke.
He's a tornado, dude.
That's it, bro. Pornhub and Twitter.
No, but let's get Tone finished.
No, it's
I get it. It's beautiful. The family.
We're talking about family.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
We know how beautiful that is. But there is going to be a time when Arnold gets to the top, and he's going to have to enjoy it, bro. And he's going to have some fun. And it's not going to be every single time a dinner with your family. Let's just be real, bro. There's going to be times where you do have to enjoy it. Yeah. And it's not saying over here, oh, bro, we're straight edge. We're so, you got to go to dinner after you win a championship. No, bro, there's just balance, homie. You have to know and remember where you came from. And you also can't let that life take you to a dark place. That's the problem.
I mean, not on the same scale, but I mean, on a smaller scale, obviously, but you know, even that, we count our victories. Our first salad show at Laugh Factory, we celebrated at some restaurant across the street.
Mm-hmm.
And it wasn't like, oh, let me go have dinner with my family or my. I go, no, like, let's
party.
Let's party a little bit.
And
like,
I was, I had a Corona with your dad. Or no,
yeah. My family still went. Yeah. You know what I mean? So, but it's just like you gotta celebrate those victories though too. Yes, but but back to going to Ryan Garcia and Arnold, like you gotta like surround yourself with some real people and somebody get tight. Because I know my boy G Money, High Tony, just my friends, just my brother, my family around me. If I'm fucking up, they're gonna tell me, fool, you're fucking up. Mm-hmm. Like, what the fuck are you, like, what are you doing, fool? You're tripping right now. Like, yeah. Pull him to the corner. Hey, fool, you're fucking up right now. I just don't think Ryan Garcia has those people in his corner.
And low-key, it's easy for us. Like I said, I'm a point and laugh. I love the, do what I do. GQ. All night.
Is it an acting money thing or no?
No, I don't think. I wish, fool.
It's hard to say. I don't think he's a good actor like that.
I'll tell you right now, if it was, like, I still don't see nobody on his side.
Yeah.
I still don't see, like, a brother with him.
He
I don't
has
see
his
a
little
best
brother.
Friend.
I just think, bro, like,
where are those people? I don't see them.
I just think it comes with the power and the money, and he's just like, I don't give a fuck who you are. I'm not listening to nobody.
Yeah. Fool, that fool got kicked out of fucking Met Stadium.
Because he was doing weird shit.
I'm sure he was snorting the fucking the foul lines.
Those are fat.
Those are fucking sick lines, Ryan Garcia.
I mean, just the
one.
Whole thing, like, and we're seeing shit with like the Puff Daddy, Meek Mills. Have you heard the audio? It's fucking disgusting.
But
as
real
fuck.
Quick, before we end this subject,
yeah.
This is what I want. This is what we should clarify, right? Is that so much media attention is going on Ryan Garcia for fucking up or being weird?
He's selling tickets. I'm watching it.
Yeah, but no one's paying attention to the real man, the real dude out there that's representing our culture, our neighborhood. That's looking good, representing, being
talking
a man,
good.
The right way
that we should look up to.
The right way.
They want to point cameras at the guy that's a fucking train wreck or is going to do something stupid, but the camera's away from the man that's out there being a real man, being a real role model for all these children, even fucking dudes to look up to. Yeah. So shout out to you, Arnold Barbosa, yes, because that's who we should be focusing on. Dudes like that, not dudes that are fucking just saying whatever the fuck they
and
want, being
crazy,
weird, dog.
Like,
unfortunately,
that's what you said, Rock.
When we seen that that documentary with you know, Dan Schneider, Quiet on Set, Nick
yeah,
Lody,
shout out to Dan Schneider.
And we see all these kids, we see these kids grow up in that kind of environment, like the Disney Channel, and like the Hollywood, like it's just insane how it goes. And now we're looking at the Puff Daddy, the Meek Mills, and all the shit's coming undone,
yeah.
Which is
yeah.
Whatever. I don't know what's true, what's not true. I don't know if the audio's true. It's disgusting. If you hear the audio of Puff Daddy smashing Meek Mills, it's pretty disgusting.
Wait,
bro.
There's an audio of him?
But it's oh, no,
don't
fool.
Even
he's listen, letting no. Meek Mills have it, bro. And it's
also he has a big
and,
one.
And it they're saying it's real. Like, everybody's saying, no, it's real. This is like actually like. Anyways, we're going back to that. We're going to celebrity stuff and this and that. I want to like. We talked about off the air, so why not? We're just shooting this shit right now. Like, O.J. Simpson, I know you're like a big stat guy, and you love what he did as far as the football career-wise, right?
I mean, yeah, obviously, I couldn't sit here and say I watched every game, and I grew up watching. But when you watch documentaries of what, how first off, hard work he put in to chase his dreams and the mm-hmm. things he did to break the culture and as far as commercials and, you know, bro, he got... He was the first African-American to get any type of sporting endorsement ever, bro. Like, this man was the most famous guy in the world. Now, not only did he break those barriers, but he broke tons of records in football, right? Like, you're talking about, what, Jim Brown's record?
Yeah.
Over 2,000, you know, rushing yards in a
and
season.
And he played like, over here in Southern California, too.
He was a Southern California player. My question was off air was, is the things that he got in trouble for or went to trial for, whether he was guilty or innocent, does that take away how good of an athlete and what he did for sports away from him? That was my question. I don't really know it, bro, because I've been seeing online that a lot of women are saying he's a piece of shit and he's burning in hell. Yes, of course. We're going to hear that. He did, you know, something that everyone in the world says he did was murder his wife, you know? Mm-hmm. Now, then I see a lot of people, older people, saying, it's the juice, bro. He was the best athlete that I've ever watched play football.
I think that's because, so we didn't grow up watching Juice really play,
no.
Right? So say, for instance, I mean, I'll put it in my eyes, like.
Barry Sanders.
Okay, I would
Kobe
say like.
Kobe or Jordan?
Kobe.
There you go.
Right? Or Jordan, yeah.
Okay.
Like, say, for instance, something happened and he was found innocent, I'm always be like, oh, that fool's innocent. You know what I'm saying? Like, oh, it did happen with Kobe, right? The Colorado issue where, yeah. with the chick. Like,
yeah.
everyone knows. I mean, to me and my, like, I fucking read about everything that girl smashed. Yeah. She even went again and they smashed again. Like, they smashed two times. Like,
whatever the story
yeah,
is. Yeah.
Yeah.
It's, she admitted that, but it closed. But a lot of people that don't like Kobe are always going to call him a fucking rapist. Yeah, but yeah, no, yeah. he didn't. Like,
it just fuel for the fire.
Yeah. But, like, with OJ, it's so difficult because, like, low key, everyone really felt like that. That fool.
He got away with it.
That fool got away with murder, dog.
So you think he did it?
Bro, it's tough.
Betting man.
Betting man?
Yeah, betting man. What are you betting on?
Oh, man.
Your kid's college tuition.
Fool, I'm going to go on black, dog.
So
he did it.
He did it, right?
I just want you guys to answer my question. Because there's no right or wrong answer.
His stats are there. It's like a Reggie Bush, like not like that, but your stats are there, bro. Either you did something bad or not, your stats are there. But for me, for what he did, and people say, well, you can't mix up the on the field, off the field things, but I think you do. Like, and me, like, I just think he's a piece of shit fool. Like, I think what he did was very bad. Like, we could joke around about if your girl cheats on you, that's what you get.
Yeah,
but at the end of the day, bro, like, you got to remember her family's still alive and they got to see this shit. Mm-hmm. And if that was my family member and this fucking piece of shit fucking killed like my sister or somebody. Yeah. And I'm seeing people today, he died. Oh, rest in peace, Juice or this. Now I'm like, you guys are what? He gets a pass because he was a good fucking football player. You don't get a good pass for being a piece of shit human being, bro. You know
what, bro? But fool, that was such a good thing you just said because we grew up like that. If you were a star football player on the varsity team in high school, you didn't have to get good grades. You passed classes with people gave you free passes for everything, dog. Like, if you got in trouble, you were out on curfew, you ditched class, like, you're still going to play the game.
Yeah.
You're still a star. You're still fucking all the bad bitches.
Yeah. But like I said, like, if people post it, like, that's your Instagram, bro. I'm not going to, like, whatever. I've never been a big death celebrity guy anyways. Yeah.
You like, hate it, huh?
I don't. Like, I just think you have a lot of life friends that you could post. Uh-huh. But you want to post a dead celebrity. Like, right. You're like, you know, there's people are starting small business or, you know, your homies rapping or your podcast. I don't, whatever. Like, you'll never post your homies, dog, that are alive. But once a celebrity dies, you even post, like, when their birthday is. Homie, you didn't post my fucking birthday. Like, that's some weird, that's some fucking goofball
shit. I feel like everyone wants to be the first to post when someone dies. Like, but like, all right, how about this? So, this is what I feel. Like, if you had a connection.
Hey, Dan, first, just fucking stop listening, you fucking weirdo.
He's a lame dog. I boned his mom.
Jose, do your job.
No, I know who he is.
Oh, you do?
I boned his mom one time.
Oh. What it was?
But she deserved it, right?
Go ahead.
I didn't OJ her. Yeah, she's still alive.
That was nice of
So, thank you. But, like, I feel it's there's athletes that did post that knew him, right? Okay. Or people that did know him.
Yeah.
If my homie died and he was a piece of shit, but that was my homie, he did something crazy, I'ma still, hey, rest in peace, my boy. Like, God will fucking take care of you, whatever. Like,
we did to all our homies.
Yeah, we do it no matter what. Everyone knows a piece of shit, dude. But like, how about like when what's that fucking Heinz, Bruce Jenner posted good riddance, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. And everyone's saying, like, bitch, you killed someone too. What are you talking about? Like, why are you out of all people should shut the fuck up? Right? Like, she fucking merged into another lane, fucking hit a car head on. The person fucking died in the other car. And got she got away with it because good lawyers, good money. Like, it's not the same type of murder. But like,
I agree with like what you said. Like, and that's a really good fucking point. Like if my homie killer, you know, whoever, like a crazy, you know, he's killed all these people and he dies, like, oh, rest in peace, homie, right in a wall, whatever. Even fools get tatted on this guy, pouring liquor for the guy.
Yeah.
But I know him. Just like G-Man said, like, OJ's homies, they have kind of a right to post him. That's because they, and Marcus Allen or whatever, know him, you know him.
Yeah.
But these, like, you don't know these, you don't know OJ, dog. Like,
no, I don't.
Like, he's not going to post your dumbass.
He wouldn't.
He's not going to, like, that's all I'm saying. But as far as that, it just, it just people for whatever, bro. Like, you want to do this celebrity shit? It's fucking it's fun. I think it's funky. I think you're a goofball if you post dead celebrities. I always said this, like, I know when Nipsey died, bro, or Kobe died, right? People driving from San Bernardino, fucking Bakersfield, 2-hour traffic, go take a picture and put flowers by his statue or at Staples Center. But you're passing by like 5 cemeteries that your family members are buried at, and you never even went there to clean their fucking tombstone, left flowers out. No. But you're gonna drive 2 hours for what? For Instagram post? I'm right here at Staples Center. That I'm right here where Nipsey died. Trick. And that's fucking weird to me, bro. Yeah. That's weird shit.
But my Theo never hit a game winning three.
So, the fuck up. But you know what I'm saying? I never, like, it's weird. Nah, hey, bro, it's goofball shit. Point, it's goofball shit, dog.
How many times you throw a fucking a soda can in the trash and you yell your Theo's name?
No, it's the same people. Me and Jimmy, I was talking about. It's the same people that are taking pictures. They never took one picture on their story with their fucking grandma. But when your grandma is dying, make sure you get the fucking hand with the bracelet taking a picture. That. Oh, I love you, Nana. Fool, when last time you visit your fucking Nana or your grandma? But now she's at the hospital. Let me hold her hand and take a picture. That's fucking goofball shit.
I told my kids, don't ever post the fucking hospital hand bracelet picture of me. That's the cheesiest shit.
It's cheesy, ever. Bro. Like, it's weird.
Post the good pictures of me. You better have some. If you love me, I mean, if you love me that much,
when you're healthy,
you're gonna have some bomb pictures of me and you together. You know what I'm saying? I don't want that fucking dead hand picture. And the hand always looks all stupid and wrinkly. Shut the fuck up.
No, so it's goofball.
I mean,
shit.
I think of what Rocky said. It makes more sense if, yeah, bro, you ain't seen that family member in 8 years and you go and do that hand thing. Now, if that's something, you know, you visit and you're with weekly, bro, and that's
My Theo probably hit like 3 foods in one night, if that makes it like smash 3 foods, if that counts. So, I mean, you got
shout out to her.
We all heard that crazy Theo, dog, that smashes, you know? So, whatever, bro. I'm just saying, hey, guys, this is No Lane. We're kind of like not even freestyle. This kind of conversation we're at. We have a lot of crazy things we want to talk about today. That went like for a while, and I didn't mind that conversation.
That was
great,
bro.
I like not having a guest.
Yeah, it's good. I knew we were going to have fun today.
It's going to be fun. I do want to get into this, guys, just real quick.
Daddy.
Nobody told me, you know, everybody says when you get married, bro, they go, oh, like, when you get married, like, you stop having sex. But, you know, I'm still in the honeymoon thing, still going on, whatever.
Fool, you've been
bro.
Married 3 weeks.
Whatever, you know? But nobody warned you, but, like, for me, I have scheduled sex now.
I have a couple married homies that do that.
And the only reason why it's scheduled is because, for instance, like, you know, we've been dating for 3 years, 4 years, and when I seen her, it was scheduled. I know she's coming to town.
It's always been scheduled.
Or I'm going to town.
Yeah.
So it's twice a week, 2 times a week. So I know how to prepare myself.
Gotcha.
And when I say prepare myself, that means like longer shower, shorter shower. So I know if she's coming Saturday, that means Friday I'm going to get my fetty out in, so I'm ready for Saturday or whatever, right?
Or you might even get a Saturday morning.
Exactly. But now I see her every day.
Okay.
So you want a divorce.
It's more random sex than anything.
You like that more.
So let's say, for instance, I'm taking a cool shower. I had an abortion in the shower.
Okay.
Miscarriage.
So you got your feria.
I got my feria. I come out of the shower. I'm smelling all bomb. Like, I had the good Axe spray. And I lay in bed.
She's horny for
and
you.
She wants to rock. Okay. She wants rockalicious.
Rock nasty.
I don't blame her.
Rock nasty, dog. And we're laying down.
I don't blame her
and
one bit.
I just, you know, I'm 45, bro. So I'm not.
You look good for 15.
I appreciate that,
no,
dog.
No, you're not like
I can't.
No, I see 45-year-olds that look
I can't
shit
go
as
like,
fuck.
Back to back like that.
Yeah.
And
back to back.
Even if I could, I don't want to.
I couldn't go back to back at 35, dog.
Right?
Chill
so
out.
So even if I could, I don't want to. I want to watch Scratch My Back and I want to watch Seinfeld.
Or Scratch My Back ends
or
it for me right
eat
there,
something
dog.
Sweet. That's I want to eat best. Something sweet.
100%.
Right?
Yes, bro. So now.
Not that pussy.
So now, like, it scares. So the other day.
Shout out to Death.
So the other day, she tells me, hey. Like, for instance, we got a plan. I'm going home tonight after the show. And she
you
goes,
are?
Hey. Yes. So she tells me, hey, we're having sex tonight. So make sure you don't fucking jack off.
On the grapevine or whatever.
You know,
for those of you that don't know, Rocky jacks off on the way home so he doesn't fall asleep.
Yeah, so we will.
Well, I don't do it every time, but I have
he does
it
every time. So they call him the grapevine stalker.
Soccer.
Soccer. Some people say soccer, if you drive by at midnight with the radio down, you'll hear him coming in the sock.
So this is a funny story. So the last time I went to the grapevine, right? I'm getting tired, you know? So
this is so
usually
weird
I got a G-Money. Usually I have this gym bag, I have extra clothes, white t-shirt, socks, Axe spray.
We call that a whole bag.
I got a whole bag on me, okay. Right? And I'm going, I go, you know what? I get my fed. I go, oh shit, I don't have my gym bag. I have nothing. But I know I have my socks on.
Oh, bro.
Been wearing socks all day. You know, I'm at the golfing range, at the gym, the whole thing, dog.
They're a little moist.
A little moist, bro. Yeah. Who doesn't, you know? So, but not moist in a good way.
No.
So I go, fuck. So I have a 2024 Prius, so it drives by itself. So I'm taking my shoes off, right?
Daddy. Are you taking your hokas off right now?
Yes. Oh, my God. So I get my socks.
Slow it down for us. Slow it down for us.
So I take my sock off, and it's a little damp.
Ooh.
And I go, oh, it's kind of wet and hot, ooh, but not in a good way.
Like moisty?
Yeah, but it's a sock.
Damn.
So I go, fuck, hold on.
Put that cock
in the
sock.
So I roll the window down, G-Money. Put the sock outside. I'm driving now.
Ooh, get natural.
And I had the sock outside just airing out.
Oh, you're just waving the white flag.
I'm giving up.
You're giving up, Daddy. You're ready.
And I had the sock outside.
Take advantage of me.
And I'm just waiting like a microwave. Is it ready yet? You know? Beep. So I'm finally, it's ready to go. Beep. Yeah. She's ready. Yeah. Gotcha. She's ready.
Yeah. Your socks are girls?
Well, yeah, if they're guys, they're just kind of gay.
Okay. What's her name?
Sockmantha.
Sockandra.
So anyway, so I'm getting my fatty in the car because it's you know, I do it, and now I'm driving home with no socks on. Because I'm not going to wear one sock.
Hokas?
Wait. Yeah, so I'm a hokas. I put my hokas on, but with no socks now.
So you finished in your socks,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, of course.
Is that why you have athlete's dick?
So then I go,
write that one down.
And this is the time I go home. So I go home, and then she wants to get fooled around this time. I go, Bray, like, I already jacked off. She'll win. Like, you were gone all day and you drove home. I go on the grapevine. You know?
Wow.
And then I go, get the sock right there. There's like the stuff in there right
oh,
now.
Oh, this is my evidence.
That's my other chick.
So that's, so now, so going back,
that's a different way of sock checking.
So going back to the scheduled sex, is that something you and Steph do? Like a scheduled sex?
I think we have before.
Yeah.
I think now it's just
how often
more
do you
random.
Get it? Do you fucking bone down?
Good question, G-Man.
I always come with these answers, bro, because they're honest, dog. If you're in a long-term relationship,
it's just when it happens?
It's no. It 1 month could be very horny.
That was funny, Turtle Ninja.
And the next month could be like, bro, one little fight could make you guys not want to fuck for 2 weeks. Like, you're living together, dog, for so many years.
What's the longest you went without having sex with Steph? Like, being like living with her? You lived with her like 15 years?
I'd say, I think about maybe a month.
About a month.
That's a long time. That's 30 days.
My chick will fucking ask me what the fuck is going on.
Yeah, but not after 12 years.
Maybe you're right.
It just, all these topics, bro, all go based off of time, bro.
Mm-hmm.
If you're married 2 years, that ain't going to be the same thing in 12 years.
There's some people, I'm sorry. What? Some people are funny in the comments. Grizzly said a funny one.
What'd he say?
So that's that Rolly Burr shit. It's Rocky's nut on the window. And then the other homie said, Ninja Turtle, he says, Rocky jacks out with the ankle socks. There's still a lot of room left.
See, those are funny comments.
I'll read those funny comments.
But
those
you know funny. What's crazy? Like, I remember a time being with my kid's mom, right? Being with my baby's mom. And I was always like the horny one,
of course.
The aggressor, like fuck, wanted to smash, right? Like wanted a bone, and I felt like often. There was a lot of, I mean, at least three times a week, right?
Okay. Yeah. Okay.
But that's I felt good. Like it was always like pressuring her, or like playing a game, or like I had a spit game to my own fucking baby's mom, and I felt like, dick, this is whack. You know what I'm saying?
That is weird.
It felt like for me to get some was just hard work. I mean, I get it. Like, but like,
and
I
you were living with her this time.
Yeah.
Wow.
So, I mean, that's a big reason where I was like, well, fuck it. Someone else is gonna fuck me. That's for sure. You know what I'm saying?
100%.
So, I know a lot of people don't look in that. Everyone will be like, oh, G-Money's a dog. But there's times I was like, she even admitted one time, like,
wow,
like I get it. I get why you went somewhere else. Like, it's just I don't, you know. And I'm like, well, fuck. Maybe we shouldn't just be together then. Like, what's the point? You know what I'm saying? Because like I tell everybody here, like, if you're not going to fuck your dude or suck your man off, somebody else will, dog. You know what I'm saying? There's always somebody else. But there's relationships where, like, I get where you're saying there could be a month, but what about there's days you want it and she don't? Like, is there a no from her?
No, I think...
Wow, she's a good rat?
I mean, fool. There's gonna respect. Be times 1,000%, dog, where both parties, dog, are not gonna wanna fuck, dog. Like,
no, but is there times you wanted and she didn't and she said
and there's been times that she's wanted and I didn't.
No, and it doesn't go through? There's no sex?
No.
There's still sex though.
Like, what do you mean?
I just think, you know, I think,
you know what I'm saying, Rock?
Yeah, I know exactly. But I think it's harder for a guy, or it's not harder for a guy, because when a girl wants to have sex and we don't want to have sex, like, we just can't get hard. Like, I'm not in the mood. Like, girls have it easy.
Where, what gets you hard?
My chick.
Mouth flowers.
Oh, yeah.
Mouth flowers.
I've never
not gotten
hard. I've never not gotten hard from mouth. I don't give a fuck, fool. Guy or girl. No. I'm just saying, like, that shit, fool.
Ninja, that it does. I'm a fuck with Turtle Ninja. He got valid points, but was there resentment with your day? Like, fuck, dog.
Yes, like, fool. Not, it would bother, like, to the point where I would even say, like, hey, like, come on, like, hey, like, oh, every time was like, oh, I'm sorry, I just wasn't feeling, or this. There's always an excuse. Wow. So I'm like, all right, cool. When I gave up.
You never said this before, dog.
I know, I mean, just.
I'm loving this.
We're in the topics.
This is dope, like, because there's a lot of married people, a lot of people in long-term relationships, and I think it all boils back down to, he always says it, it's communication, dog. If you're feeling that way, you have to feel comfortable telling your partner what you need.
Yeah, and that, right? It's okay.
No, it, like, so I always ask her, like, even if I, and we'll do adult conversation right now, you know, but I'll be honest, like, if I'm going down on my wife, I want her, I'm not like a little kid and where, well, I got mine, you know, like, no, I want my wife to get hers too. You know, so if I'm going down on her, or what, I'll ask her, am I doing it? Like, do you like it like this? Are you want this? Or she goes, no, do this. And I'll let her coach me through it, like, into what she likes.
That's dope.
And you gotta be somewhat humble and, like, and be, to put your pride, you know, your guard down. Go, not babe, but, like, how do you fucking like it?
I like when you talk to me. I like when you talk to me with a black accent.
No, but I think the open communication is so big. Like, but at the end of the day, like, I don't get chicks, my wife, period, because one time she'll come this position, and the next three times, like, I go, I'm doing the exact same position. It's hard. I remember in my head, I'm like, fucking, I'm giving you, like, I'm even doing that, the limbo where I'm getting an extra half inch, like, oh, you know what I'm talking about?
We all been there, right? Same songs on.
Like, we're like this, dog. We're like, she's on top, and I'm just going like this, like, like, he's going higher, like, what more do you want? I'm doing the fucking limbo for Matrix, and it's like, I'm doing the same shit every, like, I don't know, but it's different for, like, for me, I'm in any position, bro. It just, but those conversations.
Yeah, guys, we're always getting
nuts. Yeah, but I think those conversations are just healthy conversations for in a relationship where you need to have.
Dog. All right, how about this, Rock? You're limboing your chick, right?
The Matrix.
And she's like, I'm about to go. Don't come. Don't come. What are you going to do?
You end up coming. You come. Accident.
You fucking come so hard. Why do girls say don't come? I'm about to come. Or I like, don't tell me that.
And my girl says that a lot.
Just come.
She'll go, you better not fucking come. Oh, and she'll look at me, bro. She'll go,
tell me why it came when you said that, right?
No, she'll look at me. Sure, you better not fucking come. I go, you just made me horny.
Yes.
Like, don't watch you. Why would you say that to me? Like, you see, and she's like, better not fucking come. I go, ooh, like, damn, girl. Like,
yeah. Hey, the only thing you could say that's going to make your guy last longer is probably deeper. Because when you say deeper, you start thinking, like,
is that disrespectful, G-Money?
Fool, yes, huh? You think I'm not giving you everything?
Because G-Money,
you think I'm holding back on dick, bitch? This is all the dick I got. G-Money, you think I have spare dick in the back?
What if you did, G-Money? What if you said you're with your chick, you're fucking her,
and
you go, get tighter.
We should start saying that.
Get tighter, bitch.
That's so disrespectful.
How rude is that?
It's rude.
Get tighter. Yeah. That's so, like, don't ever fucking say go deeper. Like, you think I'm just holding back?
You know what I...
Why would, like, I'm saving it for later?
You know what?
I have dick for tomorrow?
There's no rollover minutes in this show.
Rollover dick.
There's no rollover dick.
But they can say harder.
Yeah.
Not deeper.
Harder's cool.
Right. Yeah, because sometimes we're like lagging in.
Yeah, because he's a pound different.
Or you can go smooth, R. Kelly.
Oh,
or you want can me go R. Kelly? Very hard.
Okay, watch me R. Kelly.
You went R. Kelly, Meek Mill.
What would you say?
Or Dan Schneider.
Or
Dan Schneider.
I'm done with this guy right now. He said R. Kelly and Meek Mill.
Two different styles of fucking.
Yeah.
Yeah, they're both young.
Anyway, those are open. Like, I'm learning the whole thing because I've been, like, single for so long. Like, and these girls, like, I wouldn't care if they came or not. I'm getting mine, and I hope I never fucking see you again. Like, bye.
Oh, my
like,
God.
Your cop's here, you know, so I wouldn't care. But now, like, yeah, I got to actually care if this girl gets hers or not. Like, yeah,
you're growing
I mean, once it, like, you know, like, I feel like girls orgasm, if I'm batting, it's like baseball percentage. As long as I'm batting 300, like, you, if she's coming 3 out of 10 times, I'm on an all-star team.
Full 500 is, no, give yourself 350, dog. That 300.
300 is good.
300 is real good.
No, so if I'm batting 300,
fool, you're starting on win. Any major league yeah, team I'm in the all-star. Majors, fool. Even batting 250.
Bro, you're in the all-star
team. You're on a fucking team. You're on a major league team, bro. So let's just be real.
I like that percentage, bro.
We have to think about it that way.
If she comes 3 out of 10 times, bro, I'm fucking winning, bro.
Yeah.
I'm fucking winning, bro. Like, even my ERA pitcher, like, as long as the 200, 300, 2 point.
Yeah.
So I'm a baseball dude. I'll go with that stat instead.
Yeah.
So
I'm not a closer, that's for sure.
That's 100%, dog. I know Tone has some topic you want to talk about. You want to talk about these income tax balls?
Let's take a quick break.
I'll take a quick break.
Let's go for a break. Okay. Let's take a quick break. It's
yeah,
a commercial.
We'll be right
we got to pay some bills real quick.
Pay some bills. Let's go. Welcome back. That was some weird instrumental music. I didn't put instrumental music on because I didn't want to get flagged for like.
Yeah, and shout out to all our sponsors, man. You guys mean a lot. We appreciate you guys. Thank you for being there for us and all the ones that are sticking around and coming back.
Shout out to the haters. Shout out to Rosé modding that right now. Guy, you see something stupid, Rosé is on
and
it.
And you know what? Rosé, some jokes let go by. Yeah. Like, you got to let some, like, some easy. Are funny.
Yeah.
You got to have that set. We don't mind.
Even like a stupid, a mean thing, as long as they don't keep doing it, I'm fine.
Yeah. Yeah,
like,
even one. You three strikes, you're out. Yeah, let's have that like rule. That. Three strikes, you're out.
I like that.
Go ahead, G-Money. I know you have some good topics. We don't know we're 50 minutes in. We just have to do weird
science. I know we're 50 minutes in. So yeah, I think real quick, something I did want to bring up, we didn't get to bring up yet because, I mean, we brought it up earlier when we had the but guys, I'm proud of you guys. We sold out Laugh Factory May 16th on a Thursday. It took us 3 days, and there's fools that have been posted for
Losers.
A month. No, there's fools have been posted for over a month that are
big celebrities,
and they're giving
bro.
Tickets away. They're giving. I'll go on the Facebook, and they're giving. Oh, we have 40 tickets for the first people that show up. You know what I'm saying? I mean, no disrespect to them, but yeah. I'm just giving props to us.
These are big names too.
These are big names. We got Friday now, guys. So for those of you out there that listen and you fuck with us and you couldn't come Thursday, we have the Laugh Factory in the city of Covina, May 17th. It's a Friday night show. Why not come down on a Friday, party with us? You know we're going to be fucking extra horny on a Friday. The ticket links just went on sale. We'll post it later, but we got you guys. And shout out to everyone that went to the show before, that bought the tickets for the last show. And we're telling you guys, we're not going to fucking lighten up. No lames in the way we're going right now. This is the biggest and baddest shit. And I'm just happy to be part of this motherfucking team because this is where it's at, bro.
And
this
what G-Money said about, we got the Friday show, and most people don't know this. When you're at a big place like Laugh Factory, Comedy Store, these big places, first of all, you have to earn to be there. You just can't be anybody. Even on Thursday night, if you're a nobody, you're not going to get that spot. You got to. We're very blessed that we didn't do no amateur night.
Not down there.
We didn't do amateur night and just work our way up. We kind of like, we did a good show. They're so impressed. And that's why we had a Thursday show. We got a Friday show. Friday show is something that has to be earned.
Yes.
Where you got to sell out and sell out and sell out. And then to go, okay, you know what? We'll give you a Friday, Saturday show. But because we did so well, they go, you know what? It's, they didn't give us two Thursday show if you sold out. They go, you know what? No, you guys earn a Friday show. So by us doing a Friday show, it's definitely a blessing. And it shows where we're going. And I'm sorry for the people on Thursday. I know you guys are going as work night. And you guys want to trade your tickets. It just not
we
the just, way it works.
We didn't even know we that, didn't though. Know we that. Didn't even know they were giving us the Friday. So, you know, it wasn't planned out. It just, bro, you guys jumped on the Thursday tickets because that was our only show at that moment. And we appreciate you for doing that.
Yeah,
you know what
I'm saying? If I would have known that, happy I going told, on Thursday. I would have told my family members, hey, there's a Friday show. Don't buy Thursday
know.
Tickets.
I wish I would have known. But Friday,
we didn't know that.
We just got the link, guys. We're going to be posting it all week. We hope to sell out that. I mean, I know we are because we have a strong fan base and we're just out here working and we're grinding. And I promise you this, man, you fucking spend those $30 on a ticket, you're not going to walk out disappointed. I promise you that. We got some shit ready for you
with
guys.
That being said, yeah, this is like, so right now we don't want to have guests. We talked about that. We just want to do good conversation. Right now we didn't even really come
how
with topic.
How do we do a whole hour with no guests and we're killing it?
And no topic. We're just fucking.
We're talking.
We're just talking. And
as it should be, because this is no lame.
Yes.
Dog.
But I do. Can we do some weird science right now?
Yeah. I think we should,
this
man.
This is a weird science, guys. Like, I mean, that's what we're known for. Here we go.
From my heart and from my hand, why don't people understand my intention?
We're on the wall. And we're going to be on the freeway next week. Freeway sign. Yeah. I talked to Marty. Why are we not on that freeway sign?
100%.
Right?
Here we go. No, 100%, bro. Come on, baby. My sister is 36, married, and has a beautiful daughter.
What a whore.
Here's something about her that really bugs me. She is letting social media run her life. About a month ago, she created a Facebook and IG account and has been reconnecting with old friends.
Okay.
This is all new to her. She's been with her husband for about 20 years. They're high school sweethearts. A few weeks ago, she was showing me a guy she's been talking to.
Oh, wow. God.
I told her, stop!
Fuck.
She is a married woman.
Deep Chappelle.
And she's going to ruin her marriage. She says, it's innocent and flirty, and that's all. It's just entertaining. Wow. This past weekend, she told me she met up with this guy and even hooked up with him. I couldn't believe what she was saying, guys. She's even been thinking of leaving her marriage to be with this guy. What the fuck? This is what I'm trying to prevent from happening. Should I help her fix this mess? Or should I talk to my brother-in-law?
Oh, fuck.
I'm going to start. You guys mind if we're science meeting up there right there, dog?
I like it.
It's pretty cool. If your sister's going to be, like, first of all, she's not a young chick. She's older. She's been married for a long time. I mean, you could tell her it's wrong. I'm pretty sure she knows it's wrong. And you could tell her one time, she's a grown-ass woman. She's an adult. And if she's going to do whole things, I mean, I don't think you could do too much. I wouldn't. Your loyalty to your sister should be better than your brother-in-law, for one thing. Like, you owe your sister some shit, not your brother-in-law. We had a whole conversation about the beginning. Some things you just can't prevent. Yeah. It's out of your hands. Like, it sucks, but that's the walk she's gonna go through, bro. And she's gonna sleep in her own bed. You know what I mean? It's gonna suck, bro. But I don't know, bro. It is what it is, bro. Your sister's gonna be a fucking hole. Then it sucks. That's all I can say. It sucks.
Huh? Look. You said it well. I know G Money's gonna snap on this.
Mm-hmm.
This is a very simple situation. You're the sister. Stay the fuck out of the marriage. Why are you even thinking about telling your brother-in-law? Do you want to fuck the brother-in-law too? Like, what is the purpose of doing this? This is your sister. Like you said, it's loyalty. If you have any issues with anything, talk to her about it. If she don't listen to you,
that's it.
That's it.
Tire one time.
Step away from it, bro. You're not going to change this woman's life. She's needing something. She just got on social media. It's an addiction. She's getting what she wants right now, bro.
It just sounds like her marriage got put to the test and she failed really fast through Instagram. Bro, and that's what it is. Like you got tested, you didn't pass the test.
You're not ready for social media, because if that happened in a couple weeks and you already fucked an old friend from Facebook or Instagram, bro, there's a reason why you didn't have Instagram in the first place, bro.
And we know social media is very tempting. There's a lot of things out there. 1000%. Instagram always looks like the grass is greener. It's everybody's highlight. It's their best picture. It's their best lifestyle. It's all fake. So you might, I don't know, wish her good luck, but I think you're fucked, and it is what it is. G money.
Oh, let's go. All right, where do I start? Let me start with you, the one that wrote in the question. Obviously, you're nosy.
I think her name is Maria.
All right, Maria, mind your fucking business. First off, shut the fuck up. This has nothing to do with you. I'm telling you right now, if your sister wants to go out and be a little fucking hood rat, be a little fucking hoe, guess what? She's going to be a little hood rat and be a little fucking hoe. You don't go and you don't go fucking tell her fucking her husband, no matter how hoish she is, that's going to get you nowhere. Because at the end of the day, maybe that dumbass husband's going to be back with her. And guess what? You're going to be the sister that nobody fucking talks to because they don't want you around because it's uncomfortable. So mind your motherfucking business. Let your sister be a little fucking hood rat. All right. And for hood rat sister out there, hope you're listening right now. You're probably not, because you're probably sucking random dick on fucking Instagram. But let me tap into you real quick. It's fucked up that you got an Instagram. It seems like you had a good marriage, just had a baby, and now you're on IG and you don't know how to handle it. That's what's fucking horrible, and what's sad is because every girl is a like away from thinking she's the fucking queen or the princess of the motherfucking world. No, girl. Dudes are liking pictures left and fucking right.
Yeah.
I like shit I don't even fucking really like. You know what I'm saying? So you're right there getting these likes, and you think you're a motherfucking queen. You think you're something else, and your poor husband's out there fucking working, trying to provide for you and your fucking hoe ass. That's some fucked up fucking shit. But I'm telling you right now, those likes don't go on forever. That guy got what he wanted. He fucked you, and you're gone. And that's what's sad about social media right now. This is what's crazy, because back in the days, we were like, damn, our parents lasted 16 years. My parents been married 30 years. Well, you know why? Because your fucking dad and your mom didn't have a motherfucking Instagram, because they weren't out there fucking liking away. And that's what's sad about shit. I always tripped out. How did my fucking dad get caught cheating? He had no Instagram, no cell phone. I don't fucking know. What a loser, right? How do you get caught like that?
But it's funny, because I actually said that, like, because back in my dad's still in shape, but he was younger. He was fucking on roids, shape.
And he still has.
Like, I go, man, and if my dad had an Instagram back then, like, who? I don't know. I would like to think my parents' marriage is strong enough to hold, but.
I think your mom
social
does.
Social media is fucking, it's vicious. It's strong, bro. It's definitely not for a weak marriage.
I think your mom, but your mom always empties his tank and makes sure he doesn't go out there with full gas. But, you know what I'm saying?
No, but I'm saying.
That's what we get down. Take care of your man. Social media, he's not going to be one out there cheating.
Social media is it's not evil. It's not for weak relationships, bro. It's not, but G-Money hit it on the head once again. He said, pretty much, you think the guy you're talking to, you think you're the only chick he's talking to? Let me tell you something. If this guy is a piece of shit enough to talk to a girl in a marriage that's married,
right?
He didn't talk just to, had a baby.
He didn't talk to single girls, too. He's like, oh, this is special. And if you're a married chick, most guys, I know if I was some chick and I was married, I'm not special. Like, I don't think she's a faithful chick. I mean, it's a really bad foundation. Like, let's say he takes you serious for a little bit. In back of his head, he think, nah, this girl's a cheater. She cheated on her husband for 20 years. Now, like, who am I? I'm nobody.
Yeah.
It's just a bad foundation to build a relationship. This guy is going to play you, or you're going to play him because you're going to get more likes for some other dude.
Yeah.
Like, she simply got sucked into the social media.
Suck something.
Fuck, dog. Like,
don't let these likes fuck with your love.
I mean,
100%.
From my heart and from my hand, why don't people understand my intention?
That's that vice.
We're vice.
No.
Oh, but you can fucking.
How much wood would a woodchuck chuck? That's crazy. Don't know.
My son started kindergarten this past year. And at pickup time, I met a dad, one of the other.
Wait, it's a dad fucking a dad?
I'm assuming it's a girl. I'm assuming this is a girl. Wait, why did girls cheat? I didn't even read this whole thing, but I can see where this is going.
Oh, start from the beginning, please, Rock.
My son started kindergarten this past year.
Okay.
And at pickup time, I met a dad of one of the other kids.
Okay. That's cool. That's nothing
so wrong with that. Oh, she didn't say she's in a relationship or anything yet. Okay, yeah, cool. Okay, okay. I was assuming.
You're assuming.
Well, all these chicks out there, bro. Mm. We got on a few dates, and he's very handsome, charming, and funny. Kind of like G Money. Okay, did you write this, dog?
Shut the fuck up.
She's keeping your page. He's funny, handsome, and charming like G Money, but not you.
Okay, all right. I haven't even read this.
Here's the bad. He is cheap.
Well, it is me then.
Wait, what?
He takes me to fucking
Applebee's?
No, what's that bar?
Oh, yeah. He is cheap. He never has money. Every time we do something, I pay for us, or he pays for himself.
This guy's a lame.
I love this. What are you talking about? No.
Okay, whatever are you done? Whenever we go out, he brings his own drink.
Fool! Oh,
fucking dog.
Dude, no way. I love this guy.
Oh, my God.
We didn't bring this fool on the show, dog.
He's a legend. Okay. He brings his own drinks, and he gets drunk in the parking lot. He has to be one of our friends.
Fool.
He has to be one of our friends.
That's someone in this table.
That's my dad, bro.
Is your dad right here? You know what he can communicate? He goes, I don't like black people. Wow. My ex chick is with the black guy.
You didn't say that.
Hold on. Go back. Hold on. So when we go out to a bar, he brings his own drinks and he gets drunk in a parking lot. He never offers to buy me a drink. When we watch movies at his house or my house, he always BYOB.
Bring your own beer. Yeah, at your house. Why would you?
I'm not a gold digger, but it would be nice to be taken to a nice restaurant once in a while. I wouldn't mind splitting the bill occasionally, but it just feels one-sided. I really like him, but I can't help but wonder if this is just who he is or is not that interesting or pursuing a real relationship. Should I have a conversation about the expectation or just sign to cut loss before it gets serious? I'm embarrassed if I bring it up, and I'm going to start it once again, guys.
You're a starter.
I'm a starter. So when you first start dating somebody, and I'm what you call, aka back in the past, a serial dater, you kind of want to show off a little bit. Even like my chick will get mad at me because I'm not as much. I still do, but I don't really hold the card open for all the time anymore.
Yeah.
You know, it just you know, so you go, it just.
I thought the door's open on themselves.
Yeah, like yeah. You that kind of fades away little. It shouldn't, but it does. So if this guy is doing this already, like, it's gonna get, I don't know how worse it could get.
Yeah.
But he's not even trying.
He's gonna bring his family.
And maybe, like, you shouldn't, I'm fucked right away. Like,
obviously has fucked, right?
100%, yes.
Like, they fucked, right? Because they've been on multiple dates now, right?
And she has a kid, so she's horny.
She fucks
already. Yeah,
she fucks.
You go.
Where do you go? No, I'll go. Like, I don't know what to go with. This guy's fucking a genius, right, though.
I like it.
I like this guy.
Shout out to this fool.
But I'm not dating him.
Like, I like the getting drunk in the parking lot part because that's cool. That fool, he's going to save money.
Yeah. He's a genius.
This is the thing. You met him at the kindergarten pickup. Obviously, you're forgetting the good parts because he's a good dad.
Okay.
He's there for his kid.
I like that.
All right. So, would you rather have the guy that's going to pay for all these dates but is a piece of shit father? Because if that was the case, you probably wouldn't be writing into us right now. You'd probably be okay because you're dating a baller that doesn't see his kids. So let's get back to that. Let's understand maybe his money is going towards his son that he's taking care of.
Or the alcohol in the parking lot.
I mean, no, because he's buying a bottle. If he was really an alcohol, I mean, he would be buying him at the bar.
Would you say G Money, and like, great point once again. Would you say, like, if she does really like him, sit down and go, hey, babe, like, are you okay financially? Maybe if you have extra money, maybe you can help him out. Like, babe, let me help you get that cell phone bill. Like, why don't you be a bigger woman and say, like, if you see somebody you like struggling financially and you love them and you want to work, have that open adult conversation with them. Like, hey, how are you doing financially? I don't mean nosy, but like, you could bring it up, but bring it up in a mature way. Like, 100%. Are you okay financially? Fool. Maybe I can help you out.
But
maybe,
how many?
We're literally sitting here idolizing a guy that don't have $7 to buy his girl a white girl.
Idolizing none.
No. I'm just saying, like, you said he was a legend.
Well, that's joking around.
I'm just saying, like, bro, look, this fool is kind of like, to me, like, he's not into her, dog. Like he's just fucking.
You can't say that.
You don't know what they've been through.
Fool.
You can't say.
You would never in your life go on 10 dates and not buy a woman one drink, dog.
No, but I'm saying, but.
One drink.
What, this is the thing, like, it's unfortunate. I'm going to say this. It's unfortunately to fall in love these days and go on dates, you have to be financially stable. True. You have to have money. But that's not fair. You shouldn't have to have money to fall in love with somebody, because that's what you're saying right now.
True. No, I'm not. I'm saying he's selfish because I know he has a couple bucks for a drink.
No, we don't. We don't know that. You don't know his I've been in situations, especially when I own a store where I was going to court, like, I had, like, maybe 20 bucks on me. I was really struggling. Like, if I'm being real with it, I was like, I couldn't go on dates because I had no fucking money, bro.
Yeah.
And when I did go out, I go, like, I will count the beers that I'm going to get. Like, okay, I have, like, 60 bucks on me. I could probably get, like, a Buffalo Wild Wings. I'll probably get, like, 3 or 4 beers. And I know I'm cut. And I know I go by myself with my friends, but I know I couldn't go on a date, bro. Mm. And this guy, like, I wouldn't go on a date, but this guy say, fuck it, like, I'm going to go out with her, like, and still have a good time. And maybe she needs to have the open conversation. She needs to bring it, like, hey, babe, how are you with your job? Like, maybe his ex-chick is a piece of shit and he's paying all this fucking child support.
Yeah, it goes back to an easy conversation, right? I think instead of you, like, writing, you should just be, hey, talk to him and be like, hey, babe, I'm feeling you. You're feeling me, you know? Our kids go to the same fucking school. Like, what's really going on? Like, I don't mind paying a couple bills. I don't mind you paying a couple bills. Hey, maybe we can go 50-50 the whole fucking time. You know what I'm saying? But really got to figure out what's going on. If he just doesn't like you, maybe he's just drinking to fuck you. I don't know.
Yeah.
So real quick.
Send a picture so we know what
I have had
on.
This when I first got with Steph, I haven't told a lot of people this story.
Mm-hmm. Go for it.
I was doing music. I was working mistaken. We were having it looked like I was doing very good.
Social media always looks like the
just,
way.
And back then it wasn't even really social media like that.
But because you're young, you had a rap career, so you had an image to put out.
And we had the wrapped cars and it always looks like you're doing good, right?
Yeah, the car was free.
So I went to Acapulco with her, bro. No, what's that spot right here on Garvey?
El Torito.
El Torito.
Okay.
Okay. And I sat down with Steph. And it was on karaoke night. They had a $2 tacos, the taco nights.
Whatever. Oh, it was cracking back then.
Cracking.
Yeah.
And I literally sat down and told her, look, I know it looks like I'm doing really good, but I'm broke as fuck. And before I even advance this relationship, I want to be 1,000% honest that I'm not even barely able to get by.
I love that, T.
I've been in that situation.
And Steph was
before.
Down ass chick. She said, "Don't even trip."
She paid the bill that night.
Beautiful, bro.
You know, and
I let you hit.
But that's what I'm saying, because you're open with
I don't know.
But you're open with the communication. That's what I'm saying. Like, she needs to be open with the communication. Like,
so you could be mad at that guy right now, how you were earlier, but you were that guy.
You were that guy.
But listen. But there was
this Steph right
there. No, but there was dates before that we went to Del Taco, got 40s and drank them in my car.
That's
like,
fun.
We've done that. Like, we did the cheap dates.
Yeah.
But you know where he's coming from, man.
I understand that. But for being so, but I still bought her a couple tacos, dog, at Del Taco. Like, you could still, I just don't see how this guy, bro, cannot afford $3 to $4 on a girl's drink.
No, I get it. No,
I'm sure he bought her one drink. That, she's just,
it's probably exaggerating a little bit. Look at, like, and one thing, it's not a lot to impress guys.
Yeah.
Like, and me and my two were just talking about, our first date, it was Valentine's Day, you know? Went to Valentine's in Orange County, went to a nice fancy restaurant. I went to the bathroom, washed my hands. I came back. She paid the bill. No, I got it.
So dope.
Bro. I got it. Like, my chick is not afraid to pull out the book. Like, you know, I'll say the checkbook. I'm old, you know? Like, she's not afraid. Like, no, I got it. Like we go to the movies. Like, I bought the tickets. Yo, I'm getting popcorn.
Getting
I got nachos.
Yeah, I got the snacks.
As it should be.
But not every time. But, like, all right, we're buying food. No, I got it, babe, or whatever. Like, bro,
that's teamwork, dog.
It's just, it is, but it's not every time. But the time she does, I fucking love it. You feel
so good in here,
I feel, man. You know what I mean?
1,000%.
I just think it comes down to, it goes, like we said,
how much you love that person.
It goes to sex. It goes anything in a relationship. It has to be open communication. So you need to ask him. It sucks, but hey, like, I'm feeling this type of way, kind of. Like, are you okay? And if you're not, let's help you get that better job. Or you're paying too much child support. Let's get you that lawyer, attorney. Like, you got to figure out together. If not, then you're going to resent the motherfucker.
Yeah,
like,
it's already starting off in a bad.
It's already starting off for now. Let's go. These are fucking, man, just love Weird Science. Fucking good shit right here.
I wish to say this. Yeah.
Woo! Save that tone. Here we go. Another Weird Science, guys.
Still that
I know people are love the Weird Science. Shit's cheaper in Vegas for Rocky. Turtle, it's definitely cheaper in Vegas for my boy. Trust me, I know that. Last week, I went to see Fluffy at the comedy club. Oh, no. Oh, never mind. What did I say Fluffy for?
Because you're horny.
He was on it. You were on it.
Did not say Fluffy, dog. Last week, I went to go see Concrete. I'll tell you later. Last week, I go, sorry, Concrete. Concrete, my boy.
Start all over. Put the song again.
Okay.
Yeah.
Can't be mad at me.
Start all over, dog.
Here we go, dog. My bad, bro.
Why don't people understand my intention?
Hey, let's go!
I with Concrete the other day, and Fluffy called him for some whatever the fuck. And anyways, last week I went to see Concrete at some comedy place in Fresno. Oh, I was there. Say hi to me, fucker. I ran to my ex-boyfriend way back in the day. It's been over 20 years seeing him and brought back so many great memories. The funny thing is, we end up catching up after the show. Turns out he's divorced too, just like me.
Oh, all right.
This is nice.
We reminisce about old times. Aww. We laughed a lot. And there was definitely a spark there again.
All right, I like this.
Here's the problem.
Oh, fuck.
Back then, things didn't work out for a reason. But we were young and maybe a little immature.
Mm-hmm. Happens.
Now we're both older, wiser, hopefully, and in completely different places in life. Part of me wondered if this could be a second chance, and another part of me worried if it's getting myself in the same situation as last time. Should I give things another shot, or is it best to leave the past in the past? Tone, I want to hear you, Tone.
Let me tell you this.
Hasta mi perrito. We got funny people here today. I'm fucking loving this crowd.
That's Petey. What's up, Petey Pablo?
Let's go, dog.
This is not a coincidence, okay? You guys are both divorced.
Stop, Creep. Okay, sorry, Tone.
And the stars just aligned at times, bro. You know what I'm saying? Like, if first off, don't try this and don't go forward with it if you're already second guessing if things are going to go back to the way they were when you said you were young, immature, dumb. If you say you're grown and you matured and in a different place in life, then stop being negative and just go with the flow. This could be one of them stories where they say, if it's going to work, it's going to work eventually in time. And right now is the time to find out that theory. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
I like it. I say go with it.
I'll say it just, honestly, to me, it depends what was the problem the first time. Like, was he hitting you? Like,
true.
If he cheated on you younger, I mean, just happens. We're young and dumb and true. We don't give a fuck. Like, yeah. It is what it is. And I believe, like, a cheater could change. You know? Hello. It just depends what the situation was.
You're
but
absolutely
if it
right.
wasn't that bad where you see him in person.
Hello.
Yeah. Hey, everybody. But if it can't be that bad if you see him at Concrete in Fresno and you guys reminisce, it couldn't be that toxic, right?
No.
It doesn't seem like you hate the dude and you guys caught up. So I would say yeah, they're both grown like and hopefully wiser. Like, why not give it a fucking second chance, dude? Like, why the fuck not?
That's
like,
a true love story, like, bro, if it works.
And me and G-Money know some, I think that photographer guy who got married, but he got back with his ex chick because that was his true love. What? That's a weird story. But yeah, I don't know where I was going with that. Cut me off, somebody. No, I'm just saying, like, why not fucking give it a second chance? It doesn't seem like it was nothing that crazy. G-Money.
Look.
Does he have $10 to buy?
Take it real quick, baby girl. You were at a comedy show, single, obviously without a romantic partner. He was at a comedy show, single, without a romantic partner. Mm. You guys, eventually, there was a reason you guys met there. If you don't believe in shit like that, I think there was a reason you guys met up at that point to be there together.
God.
You know what I'm saying? Something happened. Yeah. And look, fool, you have no man. What do you have to lose? Go on a couple dates with him. If it don't work out, bitch, you were already at a comedy show by yourself.
Can't get worse than that.
You can't get, you already fucked before.
And
like,
a comedy club is somewhere you don't go by yourself. You need a date. That's where they both went single.
So you both went single like losers? That was kind of weird. You guys probably deserve each other. Like, let them go.
I think they were with like their friends, dog.
I mean, they didn't go solo, but I know they were with their friends.
I would hope not.
But like, come on, go fucking try it. What is it gonna hurt?
I like
you were
that.
Already at a comedy show without a date.
Yeah.
He was already at a comedy show without a date. Guess what? What's a couple more dates with an actual date?
I got an idea.
You guys fuck, you fuck. If you don't, well.
I got an idea. I'm gonna throw it out there.
What is
invite
it?
Invite him to our show.
If you invite him, we'll get you VIP tickets on us.
Yep. Let's go.
Sit front row. Hit us up. But you got to bring the motherfucker.
Yeah.
I would love to see that. And hey, we'll pay for the date.
I would love
how
to see
about
that. How
you invite him and you spend your gas and you tell him the dates on you and see how that night goes? I like that.
Yeah.
I'm excited. I think on all the weird science questions, I really liked the one before this. That was really good about the broke shit going on dates. I think that was really good. But like, yeah, I think we all agree. Like, fuck it. Like, give a second chance. You're older. Obviously, you're still attracted to each other.
Like, I like it, bro. We all agreed, right?
Yeah.
Just go with the punches. Go with the flow.
With that being said, we're 1 hour 20 minutes done with this. I really love the weird science. I love the whole episode. I was just us talking this way it should be.
Yeah.
And we gotta get you to talking to each other because this we're gonna do a lot of live shows coming up, guys. A lot of live shows. And we are not powered by guests, and this is just something you can listen to in a car. Obviously, not this one, but we are gonna go really big. We're gonna go heavy, guys, with some audio shit, right? Talk about that G Money.
Yeah. I was here yesterday, and maybe it's me that drained the batteries, but
that makes sense.
Okay.
Ooh, it was. I didn't want to say nothing until I figured it out. Okay. But I learned how to use. The fucking iPad. I learned how to use everything.
You're a producer.
So no, I'm not. Brian helped me out a lot. So I'm going to start. I want to put out a show every other Monday. So, I mean, like if anyone wants to come in, I know Rocky could put out one the other Monday. So if you guys want, just let
every
it be known.
Monday audio for sure.
Every Monday, you're going to get hit with the fucking audio of No Lanes.
I like that.
And we want to make these YouTube kind of like our audio. Just you can see us. Because I feel like. And like I said, with all due respect, but I felt like having guests, we held back our conversation.
Yeah.
We held back what made No Lames, you know, what made Rocky Nash and whatever. Like, the guests, we kind of have to cater to them a little bit, and we can't talk about this kind of shit. And just get some really good, I like to listen to good shit when I'm driving, bro. Like, this is something I would like to listen to. So we just want to get just us today. If we make it, it's because of us.
Yeah. Nobody and we else. Are. And it came away, it took a lot away from, like, I know. I would talk about it all the time. Like, this is the best fucking podcast. We got the best motherfucking hosts. We fucking have the best topics, the best fucking, we're putting out the best work. But when you have a guest, it's kind of hard because you're letting the guests come into your house and just, they're just guests. You know what I'm saying? So now, fool, we're going to go full throttle. I don't give a fuck. Like, I'll still speak to this day. Like, No Lames is the best fucking podcast out there. When it comes down to it, word by word, no one's fucking with us. And it's cool. I'm going to let you guys know, like, look at where we're going. And we're not going to stop. Right now, the pedal's to the metal. And I'm glad I have a team that I have right now. Because if I fucking slip and fall, no one's going to fucking kick me. They're going to pick me up. Because I got fucking Rocky and I got High Tone on my side. If I'm having a bad day, guess what? These motherfuckers are good enough to have a great day. And they'll be right there to pick me up. And that's the difference between us and other shows. We got a team full of fucking soldiers that show love too. We're not trying to see each other fall. We're not trying to see each other go down. We're trying to lift each other up. And that's what separates us from other motherfucking shows. So No Lames is where it's at. No Lames is where it's going to be. Don't forget, yeah. May 17th is where we're at. Friday, Laugh Factory. Guys. Friday night. Get some fucking tickets, you know.
Guys, tell our friend right now. Yeah, tell our friend right now that we have tickets available for Friday the 17th. We're gonna sell. It's going to sell out, guys. The show's not for 3 weeks, so... Friday didn't sell regardless. Laugh Factory, we got this shit. We also, I do want to introduce, we do have another host, not for the table, but we have somebody on the team, Jay from Riv.
Jay from Riv, man.
You guys have probably seen him all over TikTok. He's a fucking viral sensation, dude. Bro. Like, young, hungry, humble.
Handsome. Average weenie like ours.
Very average.
We do a dick check.
Yeah. We do a dick check.
He does last quite a bit longer than us, but
we'll get he's into younger. That later. This guy fucks 40 minutes, bro.
So Jay from Riv, bro, is going to be doing a lot. He's going to be on the ground for us, man. He's going to put the social media on a different platform, hard worker, man. We're excited, bro. We're just going to continue to build the team, you know, with not only just other influencers, photographers, videographers. Like, the team has to be strong, bro, and... You know what I'm saying? Like, you only are as strong as your weakest link.
I said this 100 times before we go, man. The only thing that will stop us is ourselves, and that's our pride and our stubbornness. But other than that, like, our team, and I'm talking about management. I'm talking about, like, you know, like, concrete people in our circle. Like, there's no way we could lose. Mm-mm. I mean, we, like I said, like, the thing about our podcast and other podcasts is that we don't need a guest to have a show. Another podcast needs a guest. No guest, no show.
And you know what? I don't care what's going on with beef or who's hating each other or what's... Fool, fuck that shit. Dog. You know what I'm saying? That's embarrassing.
Like, talk about it right now. Like, yeah, like, I don't do pod beef.
Bro,
if I did, I'll see you in person, I guess.
This episode shows it all, bro. We can have a full-blown locker room conversation. It could go by. An hour and 30 can go by like that because we are in the vibe. And we are just homies talking, bro. And that's what No Lames is about. And that's why I feel the opportunity and just blessed to be on the show, bro. And I love it. Make sure to get your tickets. Send a link to your friend. Mm-hmm. Tell your mom, your aunt, your grandma. It's fun for everybody, bro. It's not just a young thing. It's not just an old thing. We want everybody there supporting. Even if you got your tickets for Thursday, invite some more friends for Friday, bro. We love you guys.
Yeah. And one thing before we go, we have a lot of people on. Please. Like, share this episode. Go on your Instagram, take a screenshot, share that we're on fucking YouTube and we're killing it. We appreciate all the love. We wouldn't do this shit without you guys. It means the motherfucking world. Like I said, we'd rather have